Hey up, baggers! Bertie Bagger here, long time no see. Where's he been, they all ask? Yeah, apologies, I haven't been able to put any videos up for a while. Various reasons. I jacked me job in, so I've been flitting between a couple of temporary jobs until I find myself a proper job. So I haven't had the time. Again, time being the reason. It takes ages to do these videos. So you know, they get you down a bit when you if you've got a load of them to do, and with the family running round, bless them, it takes a bit of work to fit them all in. However, in fact, I've even got a couple of old videos I think I've got footage of and haven't even done and uploaded. So I don't know whether you'd want a video from the past, but we'll see. Leave a comment if you do. So how did it all end up, the series? Well, the last three matches, I fished terribly. Well, I didn't fish terribly, I just, the fish weren't there, didn't do very well. But I did good enough to hold on to second in the league. Good old Gerald Large, the feeder king. Just to rub salt into the wounds, I think he won two of the last three, even though he was already way out in front, so he smashed the league this year, which is great to see. Lovely bloke, well done Gerald, Super G. I got second, and then Dave Matson and Stu Miles came joint third, Stu relinquishing his second place spot, not challenging for the second place spot because he decided to go on holiday to Mexico. What would you rather do, go fishing or go Mexico? Yeah, go Mexico. Same here, unlike some other unnamed people. Yes, definitely go to Mexico. So he finished joint third. I think Bob was, I can't remember, he was fourth and fifth. Fourth would have been made up of the joint third. So fifth, I think, was Bob Pritchard. Well done, Bob, in the top five again, same as last year. So that was the end of the series, all good. So I've decided to get the kit out again today, the filming kit, just because I'm going somewhere different. I've never set eyes on the place before, and it's a different format. Where's he going, baggers? He's off to Western Pools in Oswestry. Stu's 50th birthday bash, he's put it on himself, fair play to him, asked us a load of us to come along, and we're off here. Now, as you know, baggers, I prefer me natural venues, me canals and me natural pools, so we're off somewhere which goes against me grain, I suppose, a bit, goes against me comfort grain, should I say. Not what I'm used to, not what I like doing, but it's nice now and again for a change, so. We're not getting into the old debate of commercial versus natural, because there's space for both, in my opinion. You got your four different disciplines, really. You got your all-out specimen carp lads. You got your river anglers. You got your natural anglers like me, and you got your commercial guys. All different formats to meet varying demands in the market. Simple as that. There's no one place fits all, or you know, this is the better way of fishing, this is proper fishing, not just chuck all your bait in and wait for it. My way is skill, this is the proper way. I've heard it all, you know what I'm on about, baggers. Each discipline meets a certain demand for the market. So commercial boys tend to be younger lads, and to be honest, the attitudes of the younger generation, they want everything and they want it now. So if you want a nice tug, you want to be guaranteed to catch fish, which a lot of people, you know, when I've had some bad days on the naturals, catching sod all, or, you know, you want to catch a few fish, you go to these places and you're guaranteed to catch some fish, which is great. That fulfills their appetite. For me, I don't like manicured places, you know, I don't like nice stone paths, tarmac paths. dug out to a certain kidney shape or a man-made canal. Don't like all that. Nothing against it, just don't like it. Now, 20 years time, I might be quite appreciative of a manicured flat level path from the car park, or the ability to park right behind your peg with a nice flat level non-slip peg with lots of space. Yeah, that might be ideal when I'm old, and obviously that ticks the box for the veterans of the sport, so no qualms there. But it's also about fishing. Isn't all about catching fish. Okay, it's about where you go, the venue, what it looks like, how you feel, and what you're catching. I'm also not a fan of going solely for carp. Okay, canal fishing, you know, naturals, what I keep saying, you never know what you're going to catch, and that is part of the excitement of it. Coming here today, okay, they've got eyed. And I think they've got a few tension. We're on the Weirpool, by the way, on Western. But it's mainly F1s and carp. So if you're going commercial, you know you're going for F1s and carp. I'd like to see a different fish, that's all. That's why I prefer my naturals as well. So that's the commercials. Carp lads, the same. If you've got the time, which I haven't, to spend 24, 48 week long trips in your bivvy. Done it before with my cousin, he's one of my best mates, Rigger. Hey up, Rig. Carp anglers, great. Get on it, that's what you want to do. I haven't got the time, simple as that. And to be honest, fishing's not the be all and end all for me, so I'm happy to go for my 5 hour matches, you know, 6-7 hours with a breakfast and a chinwag after, and go home. One, I haven't got the time. Two, I don't want to be 24 hours on a bank, 48 hours. I've got other things to do. I like doing other hobbies, other interests, doing other things like that. So that's why I don't do carp fishing. River boys, again, I haven't been brought up on rivers, so don't know much about rivers. It's lovely standing. I've done it a couple of times. It's enjoyable, trotting a centrepin down. Don't get me wrong, I'd love to do a bit more of it, to be honest. And again, catch some different fish, dace, barbel. Don't get them anywhere else. You do get them in the odd commercial, obviously, the barbel, but no. There's a big difference between a river barbel and a commercial barbel. So, you know, there's nothing against each one. It's just about what you prefer. I love a natural setting in the middle of nowhere, not manicured. Don't know what you're going to catch, don't know how much you're going to catch, but what I do think is true is that people from each format, each discipline, can learn a lot from the other disciplines. And what I mean by that is, I've taken a lot off the carp anglers, talking to me mates who fish and my cousins and stuff over the years. You can learn a lot. I've certain things with my terminal tackle setups, especially when fishing the bomb, I've incorporated into my match fishing. And likewise, I've done things in a match which they raise their eyebrows to, and then but they go and try it, and then they think, bloody hell, I'll stick with that. That's a good idea. That's what it's all about. We're all there to have fun, enjoy ourselves and catch fish. So if we could all get along and pick things up off each other, great. Plus, also nice to have a toilet at these commercials as well. Always got in your bait bag, I've always got a bit of the old loo roll. But nice to go today and have a dump on a proper bog, that'd be nice. But there we go, there's another benefit for the commercial lads. But anyway, on to Weston. Like I said, never seen the place. We're on Weirpool on a Saturday, and it's had a 4-day festival all week. So this will be the fifth match in succession on that pool. So it's been bloody hammered. I haven't seen the results that have come out. I think there's one on Monday, which was 50-odd pound won it. All the other results haven't been put on, so we'll find that out when we get there. So, from what I can find out, certainly seems to be certain pegs which do better than others. I mean, certain numbered pegs don't even ever get in the frame, going back over the last few years. So that'll be interesting to see where we draw. What I do like about Eston, from what I can see online, is yes, it's been man-made, dug out with a bloody JCB, but it's not all mud banks everywhere. It's nice green vegetation, trees, reeds, rough edges all the way around. Looks nice. Looks more natural, should I say. Just the shape, really, that isn't natural, but I can put up with that for 5 hours, don't you worry. Make a nice change. And also, it'd be nice to... Also, what's nice, not just the venues in the geographical sense, is the different methods and different approaches. So today, one of my approaches will be trying to fish shallow out long on the pole, something I don't do hardly at all. Not very good at it, so it'd be nice to have a practice of that. I'm no Andy Bennett, although I've been watching a video on him how he does it, so I'll be having a go. See how we turn up these F1s, finicky little buggers, but we'll have a go. And you know, we can use that practice then and bring it into our natural fishing. And you know, when we go in the series and stuff like that, it worked last year fishing shallow on Parkers, if you remember right. Go back to that video. Yeah, that worked well when everything else was struggling. And the fish out in front of me, top two plus one, and then I'm going to have a margin swim. And I'm going to stick with that. I'm not going to change my approach today. That's what we're going with. Natural baits, casters, maggots, because I think it's going to be hard because of all the matches. It's at the time of the year, the weather's dropped, temperature's dropped. It's been smashed for 4 matches already this week. And call. That's it. I'm not going to bother with pellets. Don't like buying fishery-owned pellets. That's nothing to do with... I don't believe that's anything to do with the safeguard of the fish at all. It's just money-making for the fishery, which is great. It's a business at the end of the day, but not for me. So, we'll get there. We'll have a look round. Like I said, never been before. We'll get in the clubhouse, have a brekkie, have the draw, have the match, have the weigh-in. Stu's got some put some fodder on for after the match, so that'll be nice for his 50th. And we'll try and have a nice day. Hopefully it's going to be a nice day. 19 degrees. No, is it 19? I don't know. Anyway, mid-teens at least in the weather. Hopefully the rain keeps off. I'll see you there, baggers.
See you, baggers. So here we are on the Weir Pool. Western pools, sun shining right in my eyes. Lovely little pool. Peg 7 we've drawn. So, never fished it before. It looks a nice little peg. So, the approach today, 13 metres out on the caster. Fishing shallow. Two rigs set up, one at a foot deep. One at about 2 foot deep, which can go a bit, yeah, about 14 inches to 2 foot deep, bit of changeability in that one. I'm going to start feeding that from the off, but I'm not going to go on it straight away. I'm going to try and let some F1s move in and get settled on that. Plus I've got the sun directly in my eyes. So I'm going to start off feeding top two plus one down here, just to the right in front of me. I'm going to start off potting in corn, see if they react to a bit of noise or not. If they want noise, I'll start chucking it in by hand. And I'll try and fish that for as long as I can. It's quite deep, got about, what are we, about, looking at my rig now, about five foot deep just in front. And the margins are exactly the same, if not an inch deeper. So I've plumbed up my margin swim over there. You might just see right on the point there's two wooden posts and some boards. I'll fish right up to them boards under the overhanging tree. It looks a nice swim. Nice flat hard bottom, which is what I wanted. No silt about, I don't think. Certainly not in that margin swim anyway. Quickly show you the rigs because I'm running behind baggers like I always do. So first shallow rig is this little dibber rig. So 022 main line, no it's not, get it right, 017 main line, because I've half taken down my carp tips for the end of the year. I'm using a canal tip, so doubled up six. We'll see how we get on with that. The F1s might not be enough, but should be. 017 main line going down to a little dibber. 0.1 of a gram Garbolino dibber. I got 1, 2 number 10s dotted on the line. Give it a slow fall, foot deep. And I got 013 bottom with a size 16 banded MXC, Matrix MXC hook. So what I'm gonna do, see what they want, lift or drop in. Might not want that, might want a bit of slapping. I want it lowered in. We'll have a play around, jig it about, see what the fish want. Next rig, to find out where they're feeding in that column, I've got a 2 foot rig. So 11 DuraSlip with same line and same hook set up as the 1 foot rig. 017 main line, 013 bottom. Size 16 banded Matrix MXC. On this one, I've got a number 10 and a number 13 trimmer right under the float, and a number 10 and a number 10 down the line, evenly spaced, nice slow fall. I'll try and work out where the bites are coming in that column and then fish the right rig for that depth. Then fishing out in front, gone stronger on this. We've got 15 DuraSlip, the red, coming down to heavy float, a bit heavier than what I wanted. I wanted about half a gram, but I couldn't find my floats last night. So 0.75 Guri, rugby ball style shape. This one's a bit bigger, 022 main line, coming down 5 foot to a 6-inch hook length with a big size 12 MXC hook. Fish big bait, sweet corns, maybe a big bunch of maggots. And I've gone for a 0.7 gram Olivette just above the hook length. Normally have a shotty bulk, might change it after to a shotty bulk, don't know, but I'll stay with that for now. Get the bait down there, fish the sweet corn, top 2+1, and see how we get on. Hopefully that's a bit of a bagging, hoping that's my main banker. I'm also using that for the margin swim as well, because it's only an inch deeper. Although I've got a spare one set up ready if I need it. So that's it, main approach, cast is out. There's some bubbles out on my 13 metre line already. So hopefully that's the way to go, but we'll feed it from the off, but I won't go on it. I'll go on this sweet corn line first. Hopefully that sun moves around and get it out of my eyes. So I'll set up the camera and see how we get on today, baggers. Tight lines. Right, baggers, nearly time for the off.
Who booked this?